Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you RFID in great details. After watching this video, you will get to know how RFID is useful in development of IoT network. Let me show you outlines of this video first. So in this video, first I'll explain you basics of RFID. After that, I'll explain you components of RFID and working of RFID. After that, I'll explain you some exciting applications of RFID. At last, I'll explain advantages and disadvantages of RFID. Let me explain you first what are the basics which is there with RFID. See, RFID means what? RFID is radio frequency identification, right? So here, with the use of wireless communication, we will be identifying objects, right? So RFID is a form of wireless communication that uses radio waves to identify and track the objects. See, with the use of RFID, wirelessly we can identify the objects as well as we can track the objects. Let me give you some examples. Like as if you go somewhere in mall, then in mall there can be so many products, right? Along with the products, if you attach RFID, then without physical contact, you can identify object as well as you can track the object in larger space, right? So here, see, this RFID that is providing you wireless communication with the use of radio waves to identify and track the objects, right? See, RFID uses electromagnetic fields to automatically identify and track tags attached to the objects. So here what we will be doing is, we will be attaching tags with the object. Like you might have seen, if you go somewhere in jewelry shop, then along with chain, along with rings, RFID tags are attached. So what it does is, it identifies the object automatically without any physical contact, as well as one can track that object even. Right. So that is how wireless communication is provided with RFID technology. You will get to know that in great details once you see working and components of it. Right. See, RFID can also be used to track animals, birds, by attaching tag to them. See, if you can easily insert RFID tags in the body of animals even. So as if you want to track the animals, then you just need to insert tag inside that animal, then you can identify that animal from anywhere, as well as you can track that animal even, right? See, RFID tag contains electronically stored information. See, inside a tag there will be microchip, as well as there will be antenna along with RFID tag. So inside chip there will be some information which will gives you identification of object. And with the use of antenna, it can communicate with RFID reader. I'll show you that in components, right? So now let me explain you components first. See, in RFID system, we are having four in general components: RFID tag, antenna, RFID reader, and softwares. See, RFID tag, that is having microchip inside, plus it will be having antenna. With the use of antenna, RFID tag can communicate with RFID reader. See, RFID reader can also have antenna integrated within it. As well as, see, if you have long range communication with RFID reader, then external antenna can also be connected with RFID reader, right? So here, RFID reader will be scanning objects with the use of RFID tag. And RFID reader will be translating that information with centralized system. And once data comes to centralized system, then with the use of internet, there can be many applications, right? Right now we are just talking about one location, but you can give information of that location on internet even without human intervention, right? That is quite amazing. See, without human intervention, all the information can be given on the internet, and from internet by many applications one can design such IoT system even. Right now we are just discussing about RFID, right? Where we will be tracking object with the use of RFID tag, and here RFID reader will be having antenna integrated inside it, or there can be external antenna connected with this, by which this antenna will be communicating with RFID tag, right? Now let us talk about working of it. So here one should know, see, RFID tag is attached to the assets or objects. As I have told you, one can insert those RFID tag inside animals even, right? You can have that RFID tag with some objects, even in mall, even you will be observing tags are attached, right? See, it consists microchip and antenna within it. So there will be microchip inside, you can store some information. Some tags are available right now in the market, which is having memory capacity around 2 KB, right? So that memory is sufficient to give identification of object, right? And see, antenna is also attached with that microchip. With the use of antenna, it can communicate with RFID reader even, right? So it stores information about object being tagged to it. So when you attach that RFID tag with the object, at a time you will be doing entry of that object, like this is the object. Once you enter the that data related object, then from anywhere you can track it, right? So here inside chip you will be storing information of object, right? See, it is a transponder. It receives radio signal and gives response to the radio signals. So this RFID tag, that is a transponder. See, it is not transmitting data continuously. How it reacts is, like, you see, as if RFID reader is giving radio command over here, then it will be giving response, otherwise it will stay in sleep mode, right? And based on that, now radio signal will come over here at RFID reader, and RFID reader will be having idea about status of RFID tag, right? So here one can track the RFID tag, and that tag will be attached to the object. So one can say indirectly we are tracking the objects, right? See, it is having small memory within the chip. See, there are two types of tags. One is passive tag. Inside passive tag, you don't need to have battery, right? And those passive tags will be having shorter range. It will be having lower data rate of communication and lower efficiency. So one can have communication up to some feet only, right? Up to 30 feet, one can have communication with the use of passive tag. In passive tag, you don't have battery connected with that. Only tag will be there, right? There can be active tags are also. Those active tags are expensive, where you will be interfacing battery with it. See, these active tags will be having longer range, right? It is having higher data rate and higher efficiency. So there are two types of tag. One is battery-less tag, those are passive tags. And second is tags with battery, those are active tags, right? Based on applications, one can select the tag. See, RFID tag and RFID reader have antennas within it. So RFID tag can have antenna within it. That will definitely, that will be having antenna integrated with the tag. But with RFID reader also, there can be integrated antenna. In some applications, if you have longer range of communication, then external antenna may be interfaced with RFID reader, right? Now let us discuss about RFID reader. See, RFID reader is used to activate the tags. So first of all, see, to activate the tags, RFID reader is used. Once activation is been done, reader can detect the tags. Indirectly, you can say reader can track the object, as well as reader can identify the objects even, right? See, it will be going to collect the data from RFID tags. So it will be going to collect the data from RFID tags, where it will be sending electromagnetic signals first. Once that has been received by RFID tag, it will give response, and based on the response, reader will be tracking the object, as well as it will be identifying the object, right? See, RFID reader have scanning antenna. Scanning antenna means that antenna will be scanning RFID tag. Based on that, it will be tracking this tag and it will be identifying the tags, right? See, there can be two types of readers. One is fixed readers. Fixed readers are mounted to specific location and they track objects without human intervention. See, in fixed reader, you will be observing, we will be not having any human intervention. That will be having fixed location. Like if you go somewhere in Toll Plaza. So in Toll Plaza, fixed RFID readers will be there. Their location will be fixed. Once car comes over there, at that time it will be scanning that RFID tag. And based on scan, it will identify the object and it will be taking amount from the car owner, right? Automatically everything will happen. So some situations requires fixed readers. There are another category of RFID reader, that is mobile reader. See, mobile reader are handheld and usage is flexible, right? So mobile readers can be taken away from any location, and based on application one can take it. There will be mobility along with it, right? See, at last, fourth element that comes into the picture, that is software. So softwares are there along with RFID tag as well as along with RFID reader, and based on those softwares it will be exchanging information, and whatever information that we have, that we will be gathering over here, and that we will be providing it to final system, right? And at final system we will be doing controlling and monitoring purpose. Here, once information comes over here, that information can be uploaded on the internet, and from internet there can be many applications, right? So as if you interface this information to internet, then entire application will become IoT, right? Internet of things. But here right now we are discussing about RFID only, right? Now let me discuss about applications. See, it can be used for people tracking. Like in hospital, one can monitor the location of patients, right? So based on RFID tag inside hospital, one can monitor the location of patients, as well as there can be many parameters that can be translated with the use of RFID tag, right? Like what is the situation of patient, how much heart rate is there, blood pressure, right? Many data that can be translated with wireless communication with the use of RFID tag, right? See, it can be used in animal tracking. Like if you insert RFID tag inside animal, then many data of animal can be identified and it can be tracked. Like you can identify the location, as well as you can have health check of that particular animal with the use of RFID tag. If you attach some other sensors, then sensors can identify many data. That data also can be given on application with the use of RFID tag, right? See, security purpose also many applications are there. Like in jewelry, you see here with the ring, RFID tag is attached. So this ring can be tracked inside the location, as well as it can be easily identified, right? See, in library, books tracking can be done. Like you can observe here inside a library, there can be many sections. So for librarian, if you have RFID tag, then books tracking, that becomes very easy. The reason is, in library many students used to go and they may misplace books in different sections. So tracking of books will become easier over here if you have RFID tag, right? See, in inventory management, one can have this, where monitoring can be done, controlling can be done, storing can be done, and production can be handled over here, right? See, in document tracking also one can use it. Like if you have so many documents in some place, right? So with the use of RFID tag, one can identify the document and one can track that document even. The person don't need to see all the files inside the system, right? See, in defense also one can have applications. Like for weapon movement, it can be used, as well as for soldiers movement also one can have RFID tag. And if you have RFID tag, then based on that, commands can be given to the soldiers, right? See, next application, that is toll collection, where you see automatically Toll Plaza can take the toll from the car with the use of RFID tag, where auto pass system will be there. Here car owner don't need to wait for any time. Automatically scanning will be done, and based on scanning, automatically amount will be deducted from the account of that car owner, right? So that is how there can be so many applications. Now let me discuss about advantages. See, it is very easy to install. One can inject that inside body of animals even, right? There are many applications based on it even. See, it can store it up to 2 KB, normal RFID tag that can store it up to 2 KB, and that 2 KB data that is sufficient for object identification, right? See, without contact it can work. So that is the main thing here. Wireless communication is happening, so without contact it can work, right? See, it is small in size and it makes automation easier, right? So that is how advantages are there. Now let me discuss about disadvantages. See, this RFID system is expensive than barcode system. See, in barcode system, well-defined barcode will be there. After scanning, data can be identified, means object can be identified. So in barcode, you just have code. That's why it is less expensive. In RFID, we have microchip along with antenna. That's why it is expensive than barcode, right? See, RFID is affected by environmental factors. So, but obviously, if you have generalized applications, in that case, this RFID tag may get affected by environmental conditions. But see, there are some costlier RFID tag even that is not having that much impact with the environmental conditions, right? But obviously, there will be some effect because of environmental conditions. Environmental conditions means in rainy season, it will be a bit difficult to identify the object. Tracking will become a bit difficult, right? Even if you insert those RFIDs inside animals, animals may be roaming somewhere in random places, right? So it is highly possible sometimes they may damage RFID, or RFID may not be having that good range up to which one can have proper communication. So it is always affected by environmental conditions, right? See, security is costly. But obviously security is costly. The reason is here we will be using small RFID tag only, and based on tag only we will be doing identification, right? So that is how complete detail is there with RFID. I hope you have enjoyed this session. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.